My name is Guillaume Giplisson. I am 43 years old and live in France. Professional photographer, I am a father of two children. I have some difficulties with Shakespeare's language and not having a great talent as an actor. I did my best. Low away, praise all images and thank you, Light Painting Blog. For me, light painting is an image obtained by drawing with light without going through Photoshop. From this come many creative approaches that I consider differently. What interests me is in the subject, the narrative of the author. When knowledge and technique are at the service of the photographer's vision, the images become relevant, as in any good photographic series. Light painting has become my favorite means of expression that requires great rigor, a distinct attention, as it calls for a presence of great intensity. Light painting is my main activity, but in parallel I continue to collaborate with some magazines for which I produce news reports portraits. The idea came to me while I was at home in the dark with a maglite flashlight to contact graffiti artists and propose a collaboration to put together a book devoted exclusively for images made at night with long exposure time, during which they would draw in empty space with light instead of spray cans. Depending on the project, my team is adaptable in various geometries, but the projects that are most dear to me at the moment do not need help. They are my personal image creations, which I hope will one day find the right gallery to welcome them. For all other projects, there are at least three, always between pals. I do not have a ready-made method of work. What excites me is to find the best solutions. It is often a question of creating a dialogue between past and present to pay homage to a monument, its history, its environment, its singularities, or to highlight a company, a project, an innovation through its expertise. Then images are born instantly. Others takes a little more time to hatch. My job is to find them, without looking for them. To create, it has become a need, visceral necessity, which nothing else satisfies. I like to imagine that in the image of the stars that send us their light, allowing us to go back in time, in return, I devote my luminous expressions to the cosmos. Yes, I have some special lamps that my friend Oliver Premier has specially created. But my favorite lamp is the single basic LED, the Scripter. On the technical side, my experience and my expertise allow me to constantly push my creative limits for ever more ambitious achievements. Of course, the first artist I think of is the graffiti artist Brusque, Damental Vapors. We worked for many years together to develop light painting. This artist is a crazy creativity, making it natural, always with good taste, which makes it exceptional. I learned a lot from him. Thank you, my friend, and continue to exalt the retinas with your unparalleled creations. Logically, the second artist that I will quote, it is the only one which managed to compete thanks to its luminous drawings of dinosaurs, skeletons, and its stop motion, Darius Twin. He knew how to bring his vision to evolve the light painting and greatly contribute to make known our practice. Thanks, Darren. Third, I want to highlight the LFLP, French League Light Painting, which works to spread the light in good mood. I think that pleasure is the central element that motivates to create and envy the best motor. My best picture is always the next. More seriously, some images provide immense pleasure in their realization, and the more I play with my light, and the more it is the state that I seek, whatever the pretext. Sometimes I feel at my place, exactly, alive and happy to do. Some images represent this happiness. In this regard, I invite you to read Easy, the last book of Olivier Pouriol, that puts white words on many feelings experienced during session of creations in light. It became my manifesto. Shining my lights at the Palace of Versailles would be a unique experience. I would really like to have the chance to express myself. Many places draw my attention. I will also mention the Cambodian temples of Angkor or those of Petra in Jordan. But more broadly, all the UNESCO World Heritage sites would provide me with some very inspiring sets. The craziest experience I had with light painting is where I had to light paint at 5,000 meters altitude on the site of Alma, Chile, under one of the most beautiful skies on the planet. It was magical. The lack of oxygen, the presence of radio telescopes on this plateau Chacnantor, it was one of the most physical experiences I have known and one of the most exciting from an artistic point of view. I literally had my heart in the stars, and when to the end of my abilities, it was an extraordinary event, unforgettable. The most exciting thing is to continue to evolve this recent practice. The most difficult is the lack of knowledge of many observers, even practitioners, who still manage to confuse the work of a genuine calligrapher with that of a simple scanner using a pixel stick or other model. When I have no idea or project, I do my selection. From the action come ideas, novelties, new creative tracks. On the other hand, if I do not want to, I do something else. In the studio, I want to continue my series on pills. I have a lot of ideas to make it evolve. I also want to continue to push my creations and create a series with my dragons. I am preparing new, more successful ones. I also have some ideas for future stop motion. I just have to find the time. I think it's a very good and beautiful thing that light painting attracts so many practitioners. The excitement created by its enthusiasm is very positive. This emulation is a source of healthy competition, sharing experiences and know-how. For example, the Spanish are very active for some time now. It's nice to see. I think that light painting will gradually make its place as a practice with specializations that will not quiz to assert itself, and we have not finished seeing talent emerge. With the democratization of tools, digital devices, lamps, tutorials, and sites like yours, the practice is becoming more accessible, easier, and I cannot wait to see how all this will evolve. For my part, I intend to continue to make my contribution wholeheartedly. Often, the major flaw of new practitioners is to put too much. It is very hard to purify its compositions but we must strive towards that from the beginning. Apart from that, I will be careful of any advice. We do not all have the same aspiration, and it is a question not to limit desires, ideas that deserve to be experienced. They often give birth to other aspirations and achievements. It is how questions evolve by trial and error, by empiricism, and the courses are often convoluted.